The Fed warns of social media echo chambers that pump up meme stocks. Well guys, for the last 11 months, I've been hearing a lot of nonsense about these short squeeze stocks and people who are trading them. But I think now we reach all times high of the nonsense. I think if Fed actually focus more on the inflation rather than meme stocks, the inflation won't be 6.2%, which according to the latest data, it's the highest since 1990s. So please forget about meme stocks. Focus on inflation, please. Checkmate. Stocks that experience major volatility as a result of the social media attention, often called meme stocks, have not threatened broader financial stability so far, but could open the door to vulnerabilities, the Federal Reserve said in report on Monday. Making reports on someone who tweeted, who posted, who short squeeze stock plays are on the top of the line of the surface of the media attention. Meanwhile, at the background, all the wage increase that people were happy going back to work, all the higher wages that they receive now evaporating because the inflation just eat out everything that they got on top of the usual salaries. The Fed's twice yearly update of America's financial system include a special section of the meme stock phenomenon. It attributes the trend in which attention on Twitter, Reddit and other platforms encourage rapid inflows or out of busy stocks to new trading technologies including mobile apps and to changing demographics as younger people enter the retail trading market. In my opinion, guys, Fed should be happy that more and more individual investors are hyping, hopping on the trends, buying, selling stocks, trading crypto, right? In this way, they will be able to collect more taxes. We all know short capital gains are expensive. They contribute a lot to the budget of the government. General picture, more people trading, more customers for the government, right? More revenue source. I don't know why they're pissed off with this. I shouldn't even mention that more and more brokerage dealers are opening. I keep getting different emails from different new apps and applications to ask me to promote them here on the channel. For you guys to sign up, right? They offer different services. Some of them offer free level 2, so you will be able to have active data for free. We all know in most of the apps you have to pay for this feature. More businesses in the space, more taxes for the government. Everyone is winning. I don't get it why they're complaining about. Meme stocks like GameStop and AMC pose risks to financial stability, according to the Fed. The rate of inflation, it's not the risk for financial stability. This is why I've been saying you guys that the old school investors on the market, individual old school or institutional old school, don't like individual investors. Why? Very simple. We are bringing a lot of volatility on the market. We are unpredictable. We cannot be influenced by fundamentals or technicals. People, if you want to buy something, they're just buying it. They don't care if there is a bearish trend. They don't care if the fundamentals are bad. If they believe in something, they're gonna buy it. And this creates a lot of volatility. Being unpredictable on the market, it's not in favor of the old school guys. Because this is the way they've been making tons of money in the past. Because they know that human nature is very predictable. When there is a bearish trend, they know that a bunch of people will sell. Something that we saw with Tesla, right? Just from the news, from running the poll before the final decision for Elon Musk selling the stock was already down next day. Before we got the final decision, before we got the final disclosure for selling the shares. This is what I meant. They're predictable. But people who are trading these short squeeze stocks, these new trends are unpredictable. They cannot make money out of it. Indeed, most of these old school investors are losing money, which in my opinion, it's the real free market. My biggest concern is what they put as a last line. While wild surges in stocks like GameStop and AMC have had limited impact on the financial stability so far, this area of market should be monitored. It's funny because all the individual investors asked the government actually to follow up with all the hedge funds, all the institutional investors who, in our opinion, in some cases, are not playing by the rules. And now the government is pointing out that, you know, we have to monitor individual investors. They're the one bringing the volatility. They're the one not playing by the rules. I mean, guys, this is crazy. Honestly, I'm not so surprised, but I'm always bullish on the government. I don't know why. I'm expecting that, you know, they might do some things that doesn't make sense, but eventually they will make the right decision. This is what I think. The moment when Gary Gensler said, you know, there is a conflict of interest. You cannot, you know, have the market makers and be a hedge fund having positions. You know, it's a conflict of interest. This was the moment I realized that, you know, there is a chance. But again, this is just my opinion, guys. Let me know in the comment section, what do you guys think about this? What do you guys think about the meme stocks, the short squeeze stocks bringing volatility and risk for the financial system? Subscribe to the channel, guys. Like this video and come back for more.